passing has become increasingly scary for me. Quick story time. I'm going into the gas station here, and a gentleman goes to hold the door for me. Now, I'm walking into the gas station, and I'm kind of singing aloud to the song that was playing in the car when I had gotten out. And so I'm kind of speaking to myself, and he's very clearly holding the door for me and waiting. And so I see him, and I kind of speed up a little bit. And I'm still talking, and I see a look in his face. He hears me speak, and he rolls his eyes, shuts the door, and walks in before I could get there. I don't know if anyone else can relate to this, but as I pass more and more, I'm incredibly lucky in a lot of ways to get gendered correctly most of the time when I'm out and about. By store clerks, by strangers, they, you know, is that her, is that she, pretty consistently. That is until I open my mouth. I've been called slurs after people have given me compliments, and I've said thank you because I try to be nice. I feel so good about my body. I feel so much better in my skin, but it's also kind of unlocked a new level of anxiety for me. Just wanted to share.
Hold on.
Tag a brother in.
Hey, what'd he say? Double weave.
Oh, we're done over. Tag me in, cuz. Off the top ropes.
Oh, no. She's gonna kick out of me. You gotta tag me in.
Let me explain to y'all how I was kicked out the girls' restroom today, and I'm forbidden to go in there now because of someone lying on me. Let me explain. I am a trans girl, and I am black, and I am beautiful, and I love myself. I really don't understand why people just cannot understand that, and people cannot be found of it. I go into the girls' restroom to mind my business, and I go into the girls' restroom to do my due, and I don't do nothing else. You get what I mean? I don't go in there taking pictures of anybody. I don't go in there harassing people. I don't go in there peeking under stalls or anything. So I don't understand why I cannot go and use a restroom that I identify with. My principal pulled me to the side, and she said, you can't go in the girls' restroom no more because we have complaints. Who is complaining about what? They're saying some girls feel uncomfortable. Nobody feels uncomfortable because they could have been said that at the beginning of the year. You get what I mean? And then on top of that, nobody knew I was trans before I even announced it on social media and in school. So I had to process what she said because it's just like, what do you mean? This is where I feel safe at. So eventually I storm off because I feel discriminated against. I'm sick and tired of having to fight for my rights as a black trans girl. I really am tired. I've been shot at for being trans. I have been beat up because I was trans. I have been hate crimed because I was trans. I don't feel safe around men. Men are weird. And she told me I have to go to the guy's restroom. Who is going to go to the guy's restroom looking like this? It doesn't make any sense. Not having any parents or guardians to help you with this situation or to help you or to understand what you are going through is really triggering because it's like I had to fight, and I mean fight, for the right to use the girls' restroom. So for it to get snatched so easily really triggers me.
Well, like, most girls, when you first talk to them, they, like, automatically analyze and compare themselves to you. And then, you know, they search for where you fit in their hierarchy, and then they treat you accordingly.
What a hierarchy?
Like, how close you are to what they all collectively want to be, like, in their heads.
Right.
And, you know, even if they've, like, mastered the art of hiding it with, like, smiles and nods and small talk, it's like, you can still catch them doing it. Like their eyes wandering over your face, or you know, the quick takes up and down your body, or like they watch how your clothes hang off your torso, or like they look for what tags are on your clothes to see where you shop, or they'll watch your hands to find like fucked up cuticles or chipped nail polish. Honestly, it would be a kind of sensual experience if it wasn't so fucking terrifying.
So they want to find flaws.
Yeah, most girls.
Can we talk about how lonely it is being trans and just feeling alone, even when you have people who support you and who are there for you? Hi, my name is Alizea. I'm 17 years old and I'm a black trans girl. I've been trans for like 2 years now, and throughout my journey, I have literally, you know, been struggling and battling with depression and wanting to be accepted. It drains me the absolute most when I just sit here and I realize I'm not gonna be like any and everybody else. Wanting to be like all the other girls and wanting to go through girl problems like babes, it's a struggle. Being trans is hard. Not having trans friends that you can relate to is the biggest struggle. Like, I only have gay friends. Having gender dysphoria and body dysphoria just because you know you're not on hormones right now and you're just struggling to look in the mirror is the biggest struggle. And then looking in a mirror and trying to say, you know, that I look cute or something is getting harder and harder by the day because I'm not on hormones. It's becoming a struggle. I feel like gay people are more tolerated than trans people, and it just hurts my feelings because I witnessed it. One of my gay friends got to hang out with, you know, like the football team or whatever for like an event. They was all cool, you know, like bro type of stuff or whatever, right? And they was even being LGBTQ friendly, like they were, you know, being nice. I just never really understood that. When it comes down to a trans girl or somebody who's out of the norm, I guess, in the, you know, gay world or whatever, it's just not normal. I've been so distant with any and everybody because nobody really understands what it's like being trans. Nobody is in my shoes. Nobody goes through the things that a trans person goes through. I didn't ask to be trans, nor did I ask to receive the hate for being trans. When I go out in public now and I'm around a group of guys, they all start scattering like, you know, fish or something. Like, why? And it's only because I'm trans. And gag, it only happens to me. I could be minding my absolute business. Oh, there goes that he, she, or there goes that man that wears wigs and stuff, that man that wears hoops and earrings. Like, I really just don't like it, and I just hate it so much. I wish people could stop treating trans people like they're not humans. We're humans, we're here, and this is our life. And I wish boys would stop sitting here treating me like a boy. I nowhere near look like a boy. Nor do I act like one. Society is so just terrible. I hate it.
Hey! For me, I'm struggling with social anxiety, which means I hate myself and think everyone hates me too. Woo! Oh no, I don't think everyone is looking at me because I'm great. I think they're severely judging me because they secretly think I'm more worthless than a dead clam. Even though I have no proof that's what they're thinking and they've treated me very nicely ever since I met them. I just have a hunch.
I don't want to live in a hole anymore. It makes me feel poor.
We are poor, but we're happy.
Come see, come sabe. Anyway, the views are better above ground. Honey, I'm 7 non-Fox years old now. My father died at 7 and a half. I don't want to live in a hole anymore. And I'm going to do something about it.
I don't know what's scarier. The fact that everyone in this kingdom wants to run a sword through my heart. Or that sometimes I just want a little.
The annual report for trans people murdered in 2023 was just released. From October 1st, 2022 to September 30th, 2023, 321 trans people were killed. 94% were trans women or trans feminine people. 80% of the victims were people of color. And most of the victims were between 19 and 25 years old. Today is Trans Day of Remembrance, but no matter when you're watching this, we should remember them and say their names. I'll be showing a list of all 321 victims this past year. As I show the video, please take a minute to pause and read about these victims, and leave a comment saying their names. Rest in peace to all the victims of transphobic violence.
What happened at the girls' camp, Peppermint Patty? I finally saw the little red-haired girl that Chuck has always